as you can see, this isn't all that easy to do, especially with the auto roll here. That's why I suggest using the multi-tool to get it started. And I don't even know if you can see with me in the way, but I'm going to go ahead and start cutting this. And sometimes it's good to get large chunks of this stuff out of your way if you can. I'm going to start by cutting about an inch away from it just to get all this extra material out of my way. Do this out of the way of the camera. Sometimes it's tough. As you can see, I'm doing it in sections, getting the big material away, the excess. Not the only way you can do it, really, is the last piece. This is because you can't get very close to the trailer. This last one's a pain in the butt. Okay, yeah, I do have to go in the downward direction with the shears at about a 45 degree angle. See? Just like that. Yeah, that's cutting nice and flush. Okay, the shear is at a 45 degree angle to the wood. It's much easier after you have all that extra metal out of the way. Check your work, your cuts once in a while here. Make sure you're on. You see the angle of the camera now. Just continue that all the way down so that we're nice and flush with the curbing, and that'll be it. A little bit of finished trimming here. And there, we're good. All right, these solid front windows on the side are they're a lot of fun to deal with. I take a piece of 3/8 ply and just put it here as a guide and make some marks. A little difficult to do with only two hands. Mark here. This mark is basically for pilot holes, drill holes. Okay, so you want to get them pretty much close to the corner. Remember, the corners are going to be round, so you don't have to go all the way to the corner. Just want to know where it is that you need to cut from the other side. So we make this line, like I say, it's so we can drill some holes, and that way we can transfer the line to the other side. Here again, it's helpful to have somebody here helping you to do things like hold the aluminum in while you're tracing over the top of that piece of wood. Now, it just so happens that the Planter's Fancy Cashews nut can, the 12-ounce can, is the exact size of the radius, or the diameter if you wish, of these holes. They fit perfect. So we don't need this on the inside. We don't need to trace this. I just want to know where to stop with my pilot holes. So I'm just going to put a line here to make sure that I don't go any further with my pilot holes. One there and one here. And then I'm going to drill a hole here and a hole here so that I have a line I can scribe all the way across. You want to drill the hole so that the bottom of the hole meets up with this line. You don't want to drill under it, you want to drill above it. That way the pilot hole will disappear when you cut out the metal. You'll see how this works in a little bit. All right, so staying on the inside of the line, I'm going to drill a hole. There. One here. Remember, on top of the line, not below it. And you'll make your cut from bottom of the hole to the bottom of the hole. We do the same thing on the sides. Again, this is just for the pilot hole to drill through. We're going to want to do the same thing with the can to mark it, which I left sitting over there. We go ahead and make a mark so that we don't go any lower with our pilot hole than need be. And on the inside of the line is where we drill our hole. If you screw up a little bit, don't worry, half the thickness of the drill bit, because we're going to be covering this with glass seal. Afterwards, that whole edge will be covered with glass seal, so you can miss a tiny bit if you want. There's our holes. We have our mark up here by this existing metal. Now, if you're doing all brand new metal, you have to do this all the way around to make your cuts. And I would suggest cutting the top before you insert the bottom piece of metal. It will be much easier than cutting the whole thing out at once. Early 60s, I think about 62 or 63 was the last year, I'm not sure which, that they did this, but both Shasta and Aristocrat on their late 50s, mid to late 50s and early 60s trailers had this front side solid window with just nothing but metal around here. And these things are funnels for rain. If you look at them over the years, they increased the number of screws that they put around the thing to try and fix the problem. Finally, they just put a jalousie in there, said to heck with it. But yeah, if you want to keep to the era and have it era correct, you have to have these windows. And we've pretty much solved the problem on how to seal these things. And I show that in the Shasta videos, but I didn't show how to cut this metal. I'm going to show that now on the other side. I don't know how much you're going to see of me in here. Because I've got this zoomed in real good. It's early in the morning, that's why I got my sunglasses on. My future's so bright, I got to wear shades. But anyhow, you remember yesterday we went ahead and drilled some holes to mark our lines. These holes are inside the cut. So I'm going to use a ballpoint pen. We're going to make some lines. And I'm going to match this up here. Boy, that's perfect. So you would just go right in line with the cut that's already there. Same here. Kind of look with your level or whatever, your straight edge, and make sure that you're lining up with the line up here. And the hole. Make this line a little longer. Lining up perfect. Alright, then we're going to get out our peanut can. That's our template. So let's start on this side. Bring this down until everything meets up. And draw in your curve. That's all there is to it. Let's do the same thing here. As you can see, that's a perfect fit. I discovered that by accident one day, working on the 57. All right, now comes the cutting. Where do you see this? I think I've showed this method of cutting in some of the other videos, but I'm going to show it again. All right, now I'm using a Stanley drywall knife. It's a razor knife, but it has no slide here. Those are dangerous. You can actually cut yourself pretty bad with those. And I'm using heavy-duty drywall blades. I want to start with a brand new one. All we're going to do is we're going to scribe this line with the blade. We're going to scribe it a bunch of times here. You want to make your first one perfect. Right along your line here. So go slow. Stay on the line. Take your time. Oops, slipped. Slipped again. I usually don't have that kind of problem. Of course, I'm videoing now. I'm going to get straight in front of it. Having a hard time staying on the line for some reason. Probably because I'm videoing. I don't have these problems when I don't video. Alright. Once you have your first scribe in there, you can go along and go a little faster because you got something to follow. And if need be, you can clean this up a bit. But remember, we're going to be using glass seal all the way around this. So if you're a little off, just like with the holes that we drilled, if you're a little off, it's no big deal. But be real careful here. Going around this curve. Go a little bit at a time. Stay on the line and get your curve. Once you got your first scribe in there, the rest is a little easier. It'll follow. The knife should follow the original scribe, but take your time. Okay, I'm going to run my knife around here a couple more times to get it good and deep. Do the same thing along here and the same thing on the left side, and then I'll show you how to break it. Now, as you can see, I've scribed that pretty deep. Probably 4 to 6 scribes should do it. Should have no problem with that. Now what I'm going to do is make a cut. This is basically to get rid of excess material to make things easier on myself. So I'm just going to go ahead and start getting rid of excess material. Not too close. You don't want to get too close to the curve because you got to be able to grab the metal and bend it. Okay. I'm going to do the same thing over here. Now what we're going to do is wiggle this back and forth right here. Be careful, you can cut yourself. Give it a little bit of a bend there. And then start wiggling back and forth like this, and you see what happens? That just tears nice and easy. See, just wiggle it back and forth like that. There. See? By wiggling it back and forth, it starts tearing. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Get this out of the way. I'm going to wiggle this back and forth like that. There, see, it starts tearing. See what it does? Just by a little wiggling. Okay. Now, we got to get the main part to start going. Alright, now the thing is, we still have our round corners intact here, so I'm going to continue this cut straight down to that scribe, and the same thing over on the other side, so that we can get some more metal out of the way. Now be careful here. Now you don't want, I'm going to get some more metal out of my way this way also. Hey, be careful, because you can cut yourself with this stuff pretty easily. Okay, now I'm going to continue this cut right on down to the scribe, just like that. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. So this is what we got so far. Now we get this big piece of metal out of the way in front. You want to push the metal up against the solid framing to do this, and just start bending a little bit. I'm going to go ahead and use the knife just to make sure I'm down there all the way to the scribe. Okay. Somewhere like this, and just start working it. You don't have to bend it very far, just start working it. It'll start tearing. The more it tears, the easier it gets. Get out there. Take your time. Before you know it, that's gone. Nice, huh? Okay, now we'll do the same thing here. Hold it up against the framing and just start working it back and forth. And there it goes. And then the same thing over here. This is the cleanest way I know to make these cuts.
There you go. What could be easier than that?
Now, of course, what you'll be doing is matching this screw pattern all the way around. So you'll just want to make some marks. Go ahead and measure between these screws, see what the average is. Draw a line with your pen all the way around, and then start putting your screws in when it comes time to do that, which we will do very shortly here. And the screws that were used in here are number sixes by, you could use half inch, that's what I'm going to use. And we're not going to do that just yet. There's a time and place for everything. We'll be doing that very soon. But what you want to do is when you put these screws in, you want to get the screws in and don't cinch them down all the way, but get them pretty, you know, snug right up against the framing here. And then we'll be putting our glass in at a later time and snugging them down fully. So if you go look at the 57 Shasta, you'll see what I did to seal all that. And I may include that in this video also. We have to see here because I got to get moving on this project. But that's how you make the cut for your window, for that solid side window.